Hi, I'm Dr. Annadale, and our text for today is Chapter 1 of Darwin's On the Origin of Species. The chapter's 37 pages long. It's titled Variation Under Domestication. In this chapter, Darwin is arguing for a few things. He is arguing that domestic animals are genealogically related, that is to say, they share a common ancestor, not a different wild ancestors. Darwin also wants to argue that analysis of domestic animals shows us what cumulative selection over many generations is capable of. That is to say, it's capable of producing an immense variety of seemingly very different breeds of the same animal, and it's capable of producing varieties that are well adapted to different human desires, human circumstances, responding to the work of human breeders. Darwin in this chapter also wants to argue that domesticated animals show continual variation on all points, and that these variations can add up over time to some of the seemingly profound changes that we observe in the difference between breeds, between species. So Darwin's argument is that the variations that we see in domestic animals are not limited to just a small number of traits, but that animals and plants under domestication can vary in virtually any trait. The range of variation is quite wide. So takeaways from this chapter include that selection, artificial selection in this case, is a very powerful tool for the possible transformation of animals and plants, and that selection, in domestic selection, artificial selection, he will call it, provides us a model for understanding the common descent of seemingly divergent animals. Animals that seem to have a very different life and very different pattern may in fact be descended from many generations back, a common ancestor. So look for some of these arguments and conclusions as you're reading through chapter one. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Bye.